Hey everybody, how you doing? Working with this new microphone, so let me know how it goes. It's the one we used at the end of last week. I've got it on a boom stand now, and I'm running it through a audio equalizer and Reaper. Doing some basic testing to make sure that everything's caught up, and then we'll get started. There's Restream. There's YouTube. Hey, Chaos, how you doing? Good seeing you. I'm hoping the lost issue helps a little bit now that I have all the upgrades, so if something is on the map, I should be able to access it. But we'll see. We'll get started in about 2 minutes. Just wanted to make sure that the audio quality was decent. You might have to refresh, Buckin. Check is required. Thanks, Andrea. You're kind. I don't know what happened. I must have done like a game save or something. Hey, Skyhawk. Thanks for the host. I think he added me to his auto host list. Appreciate that. Yeah, so I did some dorking around with my new settings. I'm using a tool called Reaper, which I used to use to record for our band a long time ago. I happened to buy a license for it a long time ago. It's kind of cool to actually get to use it. But it should be more or less filtering out the sound of the air conditioning behind me and acting as a noise gate for this new microphone that's pretty close to my face right now. I can make it a little bit closer to my face. There we go. We're at the position in this game now where we have to go and find all of the keys, right? So there could be keys down here that we need to look for because there's a room we haven't been to. There are some other areas to check though. So let me zoom out. Take a look where we haven't been. We want to go to the Sky Temple at some point, right? Not entirely sure. It might be a Dark World only place. Most of these areas are already uncovered, so we want to be careful relying too closely on that. Ben is sleeping over by the window at the moment. We're in Torvis Bog right now, and there is one in Torvis Bog. Two of them, actually. Let's check the Dark World. Yeah, there's. I know there's one around this like war ritual grounds area. I think this defiled shrine we also want to get to at some point. If there's a poisoned bog. Why don't we just go to the Dark World in Torvis Bog where we are right now and try to explore around, see what we can find. Let's see. If we were to go down here, I don't think we were gonna find anything except some bonus upgrades. Gotten Bridge, Portal Chamber. Now let's just go to each portal area we know about. All of the secrets we're looking for ought to be in the Dark World. What's your new game, Mega Man? You and Ben were snuggling last night, Andrea. No kidding. Pretty intense. It was like camping. Alright, there's one this way, so let's just do that one, yeah. Okay. Those guys, if we need a bunch of ammo, which we don't really. In Disgaea. Is it Disgaea? Disgaea? I always said Disgaea. I don't know if the jury's in or out on that. Alright, we've been in this room a bajillion times, and there's a portal here, so let's take it. Phazon and Denzium. That's our magic word for. There we go, look at that. Now, what did that accomplish? There are multiples of those that we can bust up, but we gotta get more power bombs. Maybe we'll find some. We did. Right. It's one. Disgaea. Gotcha. Oh man. Pretty neat. It's a cool little bonus missile expansion. That's what I'm talking about. We're at the point in the game where we have all the upgrades, so it's a lot easier to go to a given room and figure out what you can do there once you can do everything. It's tougher when you don't know what the upcoming upgrades are to look at something and say, oh, I need the, you know, annihilator beam or whatever to progress here. Look at that. More power bombs. That's exactly what we need. Scheduled today, we are playing Metroid Prime 2 until 2 o'clock Pacific, and then at Xenoblade Chronicles 3D from 2 to 4, followed by Final Fantasy X from 4 to 6. We're changing things up a little bit as far as the games that were added under the old donation incentive system, namely that's Ogre Battle, Silent Hill 2, Secret of Monkey Island, and Albert Odyssey. I'm still going to be playing those during the week when we have extra blocks for them. But I feel like we're taking a really long time to get through them, and that's not really fair to the people who added them to the schedule. So I'll be adding some extra time on Saturdays now. Hey, we're not draining health anymore. It's the Dark World. We've got this cool light armor. Rock and roll. Saturday mornings, the block we used to use for Final Fantasy XIV, we'll now be playing through some of those titles. So if you're able to tune in on a Saturday morning, a specific Saturday morning, give me a heads up in advance, and I'll try to prioritize playing your game. If you know you're not going to be there, let me know and I'll try to deprioritize it. Either way though, I mean, eventually we'll play through all of them and beat them. It'd be nice to put like 4 hours aside for some of these titles. If you miss it, you can always tune in on YouTube. Catch up. I think so, Chaos. We'll see. That was my original plan, and you know, from talking with chat, it's true. I do get pretty nastily lost in Metroid Prime because of the distance between playthroughs. I spent about 30 minutes reacclimating myself to where I was. But I don't remember Metroid Prime. Well, first of all, Metroid Prime 1 didn't have that problem. I didn't get as horrifically lost in that game. And two, I think Metroid Prime 3 is a little bit better about pointing you where you're supposed to go next than Echoes is. So I think I'll go ahead and add it to the schedule. If we find that we have a session where I'm lost at length, what I'll do is I'll keep that block reserved for Metroid Prime. But I just won't play it on like 90-minute block weeks. We'll save it for 2-hour and 3-hour block weeks, so we have enough time to actually make some progress on it. I think that's been the core of the issue, is that we've been playing it on weeks where we only have about 90 minutes to get to it. And I spend a good chunk of that time remembering where the hell I was. Alright, so we gotta get back to the main dimension here. There's lots of things I can do in this room, I think. Portal in here that I didn't dork around with. Hey, Banana Dongle! How you doing? I saw Banana Dongle at TwitchCon. I was standing in line behind him while waiting to get in on the first day, and he had a t-shirt that had his channel name on it. I sent him a message saying, hey man, I saw your t-shirt. It's a good idea. I should do that next year. I'll probably look into doing that for next year, like thinking about making a custom Mass Effect hoodie. That's not explicitly Mass Effect, you know, it's still a black hoodie that has a little stripe on the corner, but maybe instead of the N7 it has my channel avatar or something like that. Where is this dude? He gets frozen when you dark blast him. It's good to know. Alright, Van Dungle. Still, it's nice. Like, you know, who are you going to drive with that? If you get one person, that's better than zero. Yeah, I no longer take damage in the Dark World, which is swell. AMA's got it. Maybe that would be more beneficial. Have you been to PAX before, Banana? I know this year at PAX they were handing out these, like, Twitch My Name Is badges. I had one on and I didn't get any walk-ins from it, but I imagine it's a little bit worse at TwitchCon where everybody's there trying to pimp their stream. But I would totally do it next year. It would be cool to at least get some of the smaller streamers that are looking for that. Silly. Banana, what kind of games do you stream? I checked out your channel briefly at PAX, and honestly, I haven't looked at it since then. Or, by PAX, I mean TwitchCon. Target vulnerable North Center when it opened its mouth. Target hits its stun target. Alright. What a jerk. Come on. Open your mouth. There we go. Say ah. As it were. Never been to PAX. You're missing out. It's a good time. If you ever can make it, you should go. Now, that room is suspicious as hell, isn't it? Like, there didn't seem to be any purpose to it. Is it just a shortcut? Why would they even have that there? Let me examine this area a little more closely. It could be that there's nothing actually here to interact with, but oh wait, no. Denzium. Aha. False. Hey, Xtal. How you doing, man? Oh, awesome, dude. I think I have you. I'll double check, but I'm pretty sure I have it. You added to my auto host list, so if you're streaming when I'm not online, it should throw you a host. Hey, Powerbomb expansion. Look at that. It's always worth it. I'll be doing a blind playthrough of Skyrim sometime on stream. One of my deep sins that I've never played Skyrim before. Explain to some of the folks on here that it makes me anxious to play because I'm a chronic, like, 100%er. I have to get everything in every game. And Skyrim's not the best game to feel like you need to get everything. You kind of just need to play it and have a good time. Do stuff as you bump into it, but don't count on being able to find absolutely everything. I don't think we were able to swim down here without taking a bunch of damage in the past. There might be something down here, previously inaccessible. Being able to swim in the crap is a new feature of the light suit, I want to say. Although, it doesn't seem like there's actually anything down here, right? This thing looks kind of cool, but it could just be they had to mirror the map from the light world, so that's why there's nothing there to interact with. Yeah, I'll probably do Fallout 4 on launch. I don't know if I'll give it a full block on the schedule until we beat it, but I'll at least play it on launch day and have it available. It's tough with, like, huge new games like that, since so many people will be streaming it. I'll make an exception for huge new games that I don't give a shit. I'm really excited about playing anyway, like Zelda Wii U and Mass Effect 4 and those kinds of titles. But the intent would be to eventually play through and beat Fallout 4 or Fallout 3. If it's an awesome game, we're going to play it. Alright. So what we've accomplished so far is we found a power bomb upgrade, and that's been helpful. There's nothing else in that room on the left. That's actually the room we came in when we portaled here. Sometimes the portal has a portal to return back, and sometimes it doesn't. Skyrim also is generally much prettier than Oblivion, I would say. anyone would disagree with me on that. Dark Torvis, Blooded Mire. I'm trying to see if there's anything else here that might have. Under Temple, there's a dungeon. There are areas I haven't been to in this dark area, so I'm gonna pop down there and then try to go to the dark world and explore around now that I have new capabilities available to me. Like a machine? There we go. Thought so. Hi, Kaihan! Good to see you. I miss you too. Good to see you. Jahan is our friend from Finland. This might be a one-way portal, but I'll hit it real quick. Yeah, so what's the difference in the enemy scaling between Oblivion and Skyrim? Because I've heard about that problem. The Final Fantasy VIII issue, right? I don't know if that necessarily is a candidate to make a game bad. Yeah, so we were already here. What was here before was an upgrade. There was like a missile expansion in here, so we'll pop back. So I need a dark oasis area and poison bog. Oh, poison bog is to the right. There's a totally one over there, isn't there? All right, let's go back there. Oh, very good, Jahan. If you want to pull up the YouTube at some point and tell her hello. Yes, I agree, Spikey. Game like Oblivion, where you're expected to explore all over the world, it's nice to know that you should be able to handle most of the things you're going to bump into. Ah, look at that. Hey, there's a key. That's two. I think we need seven more keys. Yeah, if y'all would throw some follows at Banana Dong, increase the payoff for that a TwitchCon t-shirt. Yeah, spreading through reality. Like I said, I'll throw you an auto host, so my system will just pick you up, and then if you're on right after I'm done, I'll manually host you too. Pop some people over. All right, Jahan. Catch you later. Thanks for hanging out. See you next time. Yeah, for sure, man. Gotta help each other out. We're the small folk, I called us, and posting, trying to give feedback about TwitchCon this year. Let's turn right. Whoa! Man, I ain't even trying to hear that. Is there like a grippy thingy? By grippy thingy, I mean grapple beam hook. Ah, bollocks. Alright, let me just kill this thing so I'm not having to worry about it anymore. Does it seem like phase? I think it does. Hold on. Let's watch it in the Dark Realm so it doesn't phase away on us. There we go. Maybe not. I think you're not supposed to shoot it with the Dark Beam. It's hard to tell what enemies punish you and don't punish you for using the dark beam, you know? It doesn't really take damage from concussive attacks, which is interesting. The annihilator beam, you say? It seems to work pretty well. Good looking out. There we go. Look at that. Andrew and I just watched Cloud Atlas last night for the first time. It was a pretty good movie. I enjoyed it. Much deep. Wow. I think when we hit this, something happens, right? Light-based weapons. Okay. Yeah. I got a platform. I got a platform. I got a platform. Hey, 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 hey. Oh, that's cool. With the annihilator beam, you're saying? Probably making better use of it. I just unlocked it. I didn't use it too much. More light beams. That's so exciting. Man, poison shit's not screwing around. Yeah, I really did enjoy Cloud Atlas. It's a Wachowski brothers movie, or I'm sorry, Wachowski siblings. Larry, who we previously knew as Larry Wachowski, transitioned to Lana Wachowski. But anyway, you know, that automatically brings some hate from people because of their style of movie making. But I think it's much closer to the original Matrix than it is to the Matrix sequels as far as its presentation. I think that there were a lot more people involved with it than just the two of them. Right, Andrew. It's a good movie. If you want to check out a, you know, movie that requires some mental gymnastics, which is a good thing. I love movies that are like that. Like, you know, Primer, for example, is a example of a mindfuckery film. I recommend it. It is not on Netflix or Amazon Prime, but you can rent it for something like $4 on Amazon. Good film. It bumped the rental prices, man. It used to be like $2 for an HD rental, and it's $4 now. It's like, starting to push into the territory of, shouldn't I just own it for that price? I liked the original Matrix film. I liked the Animatrix, and I liked the potential of the Matrix series at the end of Matrix Reloaded. With hindsight, knowing that they did not satisfactorily end the Matrix series in the third movie, I can't rightfully enjoy Matrix 2 anymore. But when I first saw it in theaters, like, oh man, there's all kinds of cool places they could go with this. I did think it was a pretty good movie. It certainly got a little bit more heavy-handed, which I didn't like. One of the things I liked about The Matrix was that it didn't beat you over the head with their message. They let you kind of figure it out. It hid some symbolism, but it got pretty in your face in Matrix 2 and 3. The thing that disappointed me the most is that the Animatrix is outstanding. If you haven't seen it, I recommend you check it out. And it has wildly different themes than what ended up being present in Matrix sequels. Themes that I would have liked to have seen more of, and I assumed I was going to see more of when I watched the Animatrix. I don't have the Sonic Boom. Right, Andrew? They made more than one Matrix? No, there's just the one. It's too bad. It'd be a great series to make some sequels to. I do not. Not yet. That is a crack. No, it's a tree branch. Look like a crack. You look like a crack. Okay. I think we want to take the. It's not the elevator, is it? No, it's a roly poly thing we gotta take. It's like on our right. Yeah, that's a ticket. Yeah, so I need to watch Mulholland Drive. Cloud Atlas was another one on the list that we crossed off this weekend. Andrea, remind me about that movie. We can do that next time we have a movie to watch. I'll mentally log it. Actually, mostly we wanted to see Cloud Atlas because they joke about it in Rick and Morty, the alternate universe where Jerry is Tom Hanks. The bad true. Yeah, the combo beams are pretty expensive, is probably the biggest issue with spending them. Alright, I am going to go to that portal. I like how Metroid Prime 1 shares music in common in one area with Super Metroid. Metroid Prime 2 has a different song in a different area. I think this is Meridia, right? I don't remember if there was a classic song in Metroid Prime 3. Tiny Rick! Let me out. Let me out. This is not a dance. I'm pleading for help. I'm screaming for help. Please come let me out. I'm dying in a vat in the garage. Watch Rick and Morty if you haven't. If you've never seen it before, I recommend skipping the first episode and coming back to it later. First episode's quite a bit like, I don't know, its tone is very different from the rest of the series. But if you come back to it after having already sold yourself on the series, you can appreciate it. I made the mistake of showing Andrew episode 1, and it's kind of poisoned the well for the show after that. Alright, we're in Dark Torvis, and there's probably shit we can do here now that we couldn't do before. There's an ammo chamber, that's exciting. The other area in the Dark Torvis bog is the catacombs, right? Which I don't know that we have access to. There's something called a crypt, which could be part of it. So let's dork around in here and see what we find. Yes, I'd say Rick and Morty is the best show ever on Adult Swim. The best, like, adult show, or Adult Swim original. It turns out that Justin Roiland, who's the voice of Rick and Morty and Lemon Grab on Adventure Time, among other things, is hilarious, but he needs someone to get him to chill out because he's also really, really, really foul. And it turns out that Dan Harmon, the guy who does... Oh, I can't get through here. Why would they even have that door? That's cruel. Can I do anything to get through here, or do I have to come at this place from a different direction? Yeah, well, that answers that question. Okay. Dan Harmon's the guy who does Community. So their teamwork. Dan Harmon's also very funny, but he kind of chills Justin Roiland out. Hey, little D-Piece, thank you. And thank you for letting me know. I appreciate that. I'll get you all set up after the stream today. That's awesome. You'll be set up for... Subblock. But probably next week I should be able to fit you in. Start thinking about a game you want to add, and don't spend any of your sphere points until I add you as a patron in my bot so that you get your discount. But thank you so much. I really appreciate that. It's through the support of viewers like you that I'm able to get this cool new microphone, new game capture device that reduces the latency, and in the long term will allow me to keep streaming after my severance money from my old job wears out. Yeah, if any of you donate, Patreon does not have an API, so it doesn't let me know when you donate or when you subscribe. So just give me a heads up. And little D-Piece, I'll send you a private message with some of the details too. The Mumble server, the forums, all that fun stuff. I think I've been here before, but just make sure to dork around here. Yeah, I feel like this is an area where we got like a secret. I'm not gonna do this again. I'm pretty sure we got an energy tank here that was a secret. And thank you so much. Alright. We wanted to take a portal from a different room. There are a number of portal options here. The one we took previously did not let us access the whole zone. So that's a shortcut to get out of the room, yeah. There's also a portal in this room somewhere, I think. What's this deal? Denzium. I'm trying to hear Denzium. There we go, look at that. The hell is this? Kind of plug? Oh, another Denzium. Alright. Drain in the water. I'm not sure what that does, girl. Oh, this thing is suspicious looking, isn't it? What's the deal? Oh, I've got a... This is now a half-pipe, isn't it? Probably with the intent of getting on these spider ball tracks? Yeah, that's cool. Clever trick. Nope. Gotta wait for it to come around. By the way, thank you, Spikey. Spikey completed the first timestamp bounty over this past weekend. He did all 13 Paper Mario videos for a grand total of 780 sphere points. So again, thank you to anyone who is able to donate, but if you're not able to and you still want to support the stream, helping me out with my time step bounties would be great. Basically what you're doing is you're going on the YouTube channel, you're watching videos that I've uploaded, and you're helping me by timestamping some of the key stuff like boss fights. You don't have to watch the whole video, you can skip around in a list. But if you write down the timestamps and give me some tags, I'll give you some sphere points to say thank you. Something that I was previously doing before I started having, you know, 700 plus hours of content on YouTube. And it takes me so much time to do by myself on top of everything else I do for stream. I figured it would be nice to give viewers something they can contribute. It's about 30 sphere points now per hour of game video, so you should get a similar return on Zelda as you do on, you know, Paper Mario or the like. I'd recommend throwing a comment on the YouTube video if you're planning on timestamping it but haven't finished it yet, just to kind of de facto reserve it. Alright, I'm gonna go up the other way. So let's do this, and this, and this. We want to pop up here, right? There we go. We're gonna do the same trick. We're gonna boost over. And then this should open the missile expansion? Question mark. Aha. Perhaps. Is going to add a way for me to get to it. It is. Look at that. Convenience incarnate. Alright, let's roll over there. On this side, right? Yep. Nice. Yeah, this is, it's very relaxing here at the end of Metroid Prime 2, having all the upgrades. You go into a room and you haven't found everything in it yet, you know that you can do everything. It's not something where you just have to come back later. We still want to use the portal that's in this room before we bounce, though. This is a portal we were stuck on at length. This might have been the longest period we were stuck. It might have been like 2 hours before we finally found this thing. A schedule update. We're playing Metroid Prime 2 for another 90 minutes, and then it's Xenoblade Chronicles 3D from 2 to 4. Followed by Final Fantasy 10 from 4 to 6. There we go. Alright, so there's likely a good reason to go north this way. Some rooms I haven't been in there. Here. See where it takes us. Hopefully the door's not blocked again. Shouldn't be, though. Didn't look like it was on the map. It's totally blocked. Huh. Guess they want us to get here from a different portal. There is one we can get from the bottom floor there. Maybe it's just there to, like, let us uncover the map so we know to come back here from a different direction. I guess that's another issue. I think it's unique to Metroid Prime 2. I don't think you really have this in Metroid Prime 1 or 3, but the maps in those games are a little bit clearer whether something is blocked or not. You know, it'll have like a colored door or something. And this one, particularly in the Dark World, areas will be blocked by like debris or something, and from looking at the map, you can't really tell. It's not like it's segmented off or anything like that. I've heard that Metroid Prime 2 is, of the three, popularly considered the least favorite among the folks, but it's still a good game. It's still an amazing game. Curious to think about, like, what happened. Did they innovate too far? Oh, there's a door here I didn't open before. Let's go hit that. So there's, it might just be a shortcut, though. Ouch. Go ahead, jump up there, right? Ooh. Used to be water we could use to get through this room. We'd strain the water. Ah, bollocks. Not all what I meant to happen, girl. Let's jump again. Yeah. Like Prime 2 more than 3? I don't think they're hated. I guess if anyone hates Metroid Prime 2 and 3, that's a pretty strong word to describe this game. It's a good game. You like 2 more than 3? Is it that 3 is more linear, hand-holdy? What drives your opinion there? We're gonna go back into the main hallway and try to progress from there. I think this is just a shortcut. It didn't take us anywhere new. Alright, so we used the portal here and that was incorrect. We're gonna go back to the center. You know, is this the poison bog? No, this is the catacombs. The last time we found something, there was a dead Luminoth in the room. I think that might be a hint. So I'm gonna take this portal and see if we can find a thing in the Dark World before I leave here. Let's do this real quick. Yes. I agree with you on that, Spikey. I didn't appreciate that as when I played Metroid Prime 3 for the first time. To me, a fundamental component of a good Metroid game is that it ought to be lonely. And Metroid Prime 3 violates that in that you're always around other people. Maybe that's not a fair requirement, but that's what I've always thought. Anything where we have to swim in murky water is probably part of the puzzle, right? What's this thing? Recording to logbook. Watch drone. Expose it to light, right? We're not gonna get all the scans. We made some mistakes earlier. Luminoth light beacon. Okay, got it. I found a secret. Hey. I should be looking for these dark purple waters everywhere, if possible. It's probably where they're all hidden. Yeah, some of the maps in 3 are really, really cool. I guess I don't think that my opinion on Metroid needing to be lonely is necessarily a deal breaker, you know? Aha. Things are almost always hidden, it looks like. There's another Sky Temple key. Thanks, Spikey. I had to do that last time. I wasn't 100% sure if that would always be required. So I'm not using an out-and-out guy, but I do have a list of the number of keys in which areas, so I happen to know that I'm done with the Dark Torvus Bog and can move on to a different zone. That said, there are some places I haven't been to yet that I should be able to access now, and I think I'll just go ahead and access them to get the extra power bombs, missiles, or whatever. If this game is anything like Metroid Prime 1, you want to have as many of those as possible, particularly for the final encounter. How do you figure, Chaos? Also, hey Leon, how you doing, man? We'll do Dark Aegon Wastes next. There's two there. Oh, really? Okay, that's good to know. I can try to hit that up here soon. Sky Temple entrance. Spikey, do you happen to know where that is? I mean, I can go through the maps and just comb through each and every area until I see the map that's named that. Is it part of the temple grounds, or...? We're in our way. Ah, okay. Let's revisit it when we get that far then, Chaos. I will probably be playing it on stream. Dark Temple Grounds? Okay, thank you. Sure, sure, that makes sense too. Yeah, totes a portal down here. Mm-hmm. Probably something that I can access now too. Oh, it looks like the game's about to show me where it is. That's cool. Ah, okay. Cool, cool. Yeah, I've been there before, but now it has it marked on the map, so that much easier to find it. Thank you for your help. Nominally, when you kill things with a certain beam, you get the ammo from the opposite beam, so you see these big crowds of enemies, you can kind of use it as a chance to restock on the beams that you're getting low on. Which I am doing. Up here. We got the Seeker missiles a long time ago, gotcha. Alright, there might could be some new stuff we can do in this general area. We'll do Kami. Sounds like y'all have similar tastes. Yeah, let's go through here. There's an Ing, which, according to Darkstar, I can just, like, zap once-ish? Not quite at once, but might be that I need to target it in the Dark Realm. I'm just gonna ignore them. I can kill them, but it's such a pain in the butt that I'm not gonna bother. Ow. Come on, there you go. Okay, so now there's a red door that I haven't been in. It might be the only thing that's in here that I haven't been in, but let's go in it anyway. Why was I not over here? Oh, I see. Oh, it's a save point. Sure. Let's see if we can hit the front now. Get back out of here. Let me just double check the map, make sure there's nothing else that's explorable in this zone now. Previously it was not explorable. I think we've got everything. Don't see any doors that lead somewhere we haven't been, right? So let's get out of Dodge. I Yeah. If they're close enough to the things that the light will damage them. Bit of a sore throat today. I might need to go get something to drink in a little bit. We'll see. Getting out of this area. Heading back up. We can just fly right up here, right? Yeah, look at that. Nice. Alright, take this elevator. See if there's a shortcut now. We've got all these shortcuts across the different zones that we can take. Let's see what's close once I get up here, though. Okay. That's the energy controller. That should have a shortcut, so I'm just going to go straight over there. Take me back to where Umos is. And I can use his area to get to the entrance to the Sky Temple, which would have the hints that Spikey was talking about.
Go.
We're going. Let's go straight. We do want to go to the Aegon Waste, but I think I want to go check out these clues first. Yeah, I think this is right. Right, there should be shortcuts in all these energy controller rooms. The new little light thing that you're allowed to ride on. Poor Donatello behind me, I need to redo the adhesive holding him to the wall. He's starting to fall off. Alright. Yep, there's a little light portal. Didn't make that up. Can I scan it? So we are saying, let's go to Great Temple. I don't think this is a skippable cutscene. Hey Luigi, how you doing? Good to see you again. And Sky Corvus, how you been? Does anybody have a favorite Samus suit? I think I like the, like, OG Varus suit. And the Fusion suit's really cool looking, too. Excited to play through Metroid Fusion again. It's a great game. I'm Sunny and not ringing. You're not a skippable cutscene. Take you downstairs. Got a Mass Effect-style elevator here. Minus the party banter. Alright, so the game just yelled at us and said, hey, here's where you're supposed to go. Okay, there is no dark world for this area. That makes sense. This is where we want to be. And there's totally a portal in that room, and it is... We want to go west to get to it, it looks like. Let's get down there first before we decide anything. I think we want to go left in here. I think. It makes sense. These things, electric dudes. You like the rainy atmosphere better, Luigi? Nintendo likes that in their Metroid and Zelda games, like, take an area that's really shitty and restore it over time. And that's the room I want to be in, so I'm going to go lefterly. Ignore these dudes, because I don't care. Ow, ow. Can you hear me? I said I don't care about them. Make sure that I'm going the right way here. Yes. Poor space pirates waiting there for Samus to show up, and she just leaves. She doesn't have time for them. Yeah, this looks right. Mm-hmm. Nobody trying to have no sunny bogs. Huh. That makes me suspect that there is a thing here in Dark World. It would be, if that's the pattern, that's a cool idea, like, hey, here's a hint as to where all the keys are. I go to places where there's dead Luminoth. Oh yeah, we opened this place forever ago, didn't we? There's some other way to get up there, isn't there? Secret platform, maybe? No, maybe not. That doesn't work. If there's anything involving this beam. Anything involving those dudes. However I get up there, I should have access to do it now. Let me try dorking around. I don't think that we need to use these anymore, but I'll try real quick just to see. Offline. Unable to restore function. Hey, Red Floxy, how you doing? This is where we came from, so we don't want to use this. I don't think I can use this to climb up there, right? It doesn't really give you any air. It gives you horizontal movement, but no vertical movement. And there's nothing for me to jump off of. It's totally where I want to go, though. I can find it. Use it. Nope. Kill the things, but I can't climb it. I'll welcome a hint from chat. How exactly do I get up there again? No, that's where I need to go, and I should have the ability to get there since I have all the upgrades. Maybe there's something I need to see with a visor that I'm not picking up at the moment. That doesn't appear to be the case either, though, does it? Emos. And it looks like the screw attack is like almost gonna make it, but not quite. Yeah, just hits the corner and doesn't go up. You can glitch up there in the GameCube version. That's interesting. All these spinners are done too, right? Might have something to do with this thing on the ground. I can look around a little bit more. This is totally where I need to be. Need to find out how to get up on that platform. Definitely doesn't involve the use of any of the visors, I think. Another dead Luminoth makes me suspicious. Might involve shooting the things with this guy, right? Ah, I see. That portal is not intended to be reached, though, is what you're saying? How am I intended to go to the Dark World in this area, right? Because the map tells me this is where I should be. And yet, I have no way to access this room from elsewhere. Well, maybe it's through here. That might be what I need to do. I need to go back to the base access and take that. Let's try that. Hey, Pedro King, how you doing? Thank you for confirming, Lulz. I appreciate it. The thing is that it is accessible, it just doesn't appear to be accessible because I haven't been through this way before in the Dark World. Sure. Thanks, guys. Is it, it has to do something, right? Is it that you can use that to return to the Light World, maybe? It seems crazy if it doesn't do anything at all. You can shoot the cool annihilator beam in there and it bounces off the walls. It doesn't do anything in particular. All right, we're gonna go up to this portal here. Straight. Oh, it's in a cutscene only? Interesting. Okay, thank you. For those of you new folks in chat, heads up, the purpose of this stream, I'm trying to play through and beat every awesome single-player game ever made. Knowing that there's too many of them to play them all in one lifetime, or trying anyway. So the Metroid series is part of that. After beating Metroid Prime 2, I'll be transitioning to Metroid Prime 3, and then we'll go through and do the other Metroid games in chronological order. Prime is the prequel, right? The first three Prime games are the first titles. No, that's not true. They're before Super Metroid. Well, either way, we'll play through Metroid, Super Metroid. Metroid Fusion, maybe Other M, as sad as it makes me, just to kind of give a critical eye on it. If you're just here for Metroid, that's cool. We'll be back on the schedule. We'll be playing it until we beat the games in the series. Just check the schedule to see when it will be on. Primes between Metroid 1 and 2. Gotcha. Yeah, tease portal. okay, so we couldn't open this before, but now we should be able to, right? Okay. Nice. Aha, one of these. Another missile expansion. Fusion's the last one, right? And there's never been a game after Fusion because it kind of permanently changes Samus' suit. Alright, Camman, good to hear. Now, Camman had lost it and was unable to play. We usually do a free play day on Wednesdays to play through games that are rad, but not beatable in the conventional sense, like Mario Maker or Smash Brothers. Alright, I'll still try to time that then. I didn't do Metroid 1 on stream, but maybe we'll do Zero Mission after Metroid 1, Prime 1, 2, and 3. Zero Mission is an outstanding game. I would hazard that it is the best remake ever made of any game. It's just, it captures the spirit of Metroid 1 for the NES, which isn't a game that's aged particularly well. And it adds a bunch of new content. It's very clean. Yeah, I could hear that, Bloxy. I'm really excited to play through it. I feel like Zero Mission is such a good game, there's little reason to play the original Metroid 1 for the NES. Watch somebody speedrun it. Look up PAX 2015 Bit Brigade Metroid. It's the band where their front man is a speedrunner, so he speedran the game while the band played music from it in the background. It was pretty rad. Ah, cool. Barapot sleeps in a flooded temple. Oh, so there are dead Luminoth there. That's cool. So no, he's looking down at the Great Bridge of a Holy Fortress. Collect my hints. This is just like the Chozo artifacts in Metroid Prime 1. I know that these are much maligned, but I feel like they're necessary. You gotta have a mechanic like this. You gotta give the player something to do with all the upgrades when they have them. Super Metroid, I used to say, was the greatest game ever made. Not my particularly my favorite game. I really, really love it. Earthbound's my favorite game, but it might be one of the best games ever made. Just the way it's designed, the depth that it has for casual players taking, you know, tens of hours to 100% it versus speedrunners taking hours to 100% it. Hey, PK Starship. You so named for the Earthbound series by chance? Fortress in the Scorchland, okay. Lies in a fortress. Yeah, so these are the keys are held by corpses. Marsh for rainy land. Alright. And there's another dead one. Yeah, I'm not a fan of the Triforce Hunt. The reason I don't like the Triforce Hunt, one, it doesn't feel like it's sending you around the game to use all your upgrades. Two, it feels like it's a stand-in for running extra dungeons. Like, it seems like the dungeon count in Wind Waker is very small. Like, they plan to include more, and that the Triforce Hunt is a stand-in for additional content. I don't know if that's ever been confirmed by Miyamoto Anuma at all, but that's my theory. Oh, good looking out, dude. Right, so their key's already in place, right? And I can place some of mine in here, too. That's good to know. Yeah, PK Starstorm, PK Starship, that's what I thought. Yeah, Earthbound Mother 3 is my favorite series of games. This game is a classic, PK. Actually, the entire Prime series are modern classics. I remember my terror when I first heard that a Texas company was making Metroid into a first-person shooter and how it ended up, everything turned out better than expected, so to speak. Alright, so that's cool. That marks the ones that we've already found in our log. We can look at the other ones if we need to, if we get lost. There's nothing else to do in this room except turn in keys, though, so we can rock out of here. One sec. Could be that there are places around here to find keys, so I'll have to look around and see. Yeah, I guess I'd, if the Triforce Hunt has to be there, I'd prefer it to be as like user-friendly as possible. I did. I'm on the Wii version, so apparently I had, I'm on the Wii version, so I had a little bit less trouble. Thank you for the follow, by the way, PK Starship. Since I'm accidentally playing on what's essentially easy difficulty, I'm on a normal mode, which turns out is technically easy mode. And also on the Wii mode, you can do a little ball jump by just like shaking the Wiimote like this. couldn't do that on the GameCube version, and that makes it easier as well. So the Spider Guardian wasn't too hard. Could have been quite a bit nastier. Wouldn't be surprised if there is something to be found here, you know? Hey, Bloat, thanks for the follow. It's good to have you. Oh, that's a really cool system. I like how you can use that to kill the Ing. Neat little trick. This is where our ship is in the Light World. Don't think that there's a key to be found in this room. Do a quick pass just to make 100% sure. Appears that there is not. You guys want to help me out. If I end up abandoning a room that does in fact have a key in it, feel free to break the, you know, usual backseat gaming prohibition and let me know, just in the interest of saving time. Let me at least go in the room and try to find it on my own first, but if I make a mistake and leave thinking that there's nothing there when in fact there was, I will welcome your advice. Fuzzy Pickles. That room did in fact have a key. Thank you, Spikey. Hey, Ludifex, how you doing, man? Good to see you again. Hey, dude, you mentioned EQing at TwitchCon. Ludifex is another person I met at TwitchCon. So I went ahead and I got Reaper installed on my machine, and I'm running some EQ for my new microphone. So if you wanted to talk to me about your EQ setup versus what I'm doing off stream at some point, send me a message and you can hop in Mumble or something and talk about it. Definitely feels much more necessary now that I have a condenser mic and I'm not talking into a headset mic. Alright, so we're gonna search this room for secrets. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting the dark visor thing. So if I'm in a room and I suspect that there might be a secret, I should checkboard in this way. Good to know. Got it. Dark visor, dark visor, dark visor. I can do this thing. I'm gonna schedule update, guys. We're playing this for another 1 hour. At 2 o'clock Pacific, we're switching to Xenoblade Chronicles 3D. If you haven't seen it before, it is the game that Shulk is from in Smash Brothers. And then from 4 to 6 Pacific, it's Final Fantasy X. Metroid Prime 2 will be returning. You can check the schedule below the stream to see the next time that it's up. When we beat it, I think I'm just going to go ahead and swap in Metroid Prime 3. But if we ever have any issues with getting excessively lost in Prime 3, I might try to reserve it for weeks or a weekend. Give it a long time block, you know, like 2 or 3 hours at a time. Yeah, right, Red Floxy? I'm very close to the end of the game. I may beat it this week. We'll see. We get about 4 hours to it this week. We still have some major boss fights to fight through. I'm going to check the abandoned base back here to see if there's anything. We might need to do a little bit of grinding to even be able to handle those boss fights, but... Heck yeah, Smash Brothers! Fire Emblem is huge thanks to Smash. How many hours am I in? I have 23 videos loaded on... Oh, that's weird. Why is that one highlighted when the other ones aren't? Oh, maybe they were and I just wasn't looking at them closely enough. They were. Okay. 23 videos at an average of like 2 to 3 hours a video, so we've been playing it for a long time. I think it has the most clocked playtime of any game on stream so far. I don't think this actually takes us anywhere that we haven't been to before. We'll take it just in case. Cool. Good to know, Red Floxy. Heck yeah, D-Rock. New mic. With a mild amount of like default EQ. Running from Reaper. So I already had a Reaper license from a couple years ago when I was starting a video game cover band with a friend. This is when we were in Columbus, Ohio. And like a few months after we had bought all the equipment and were all set up and started to record, my wife Andrea got her new job out here in California, so we weren't able to continue. But it ended up being worth it because I get to use the Reaper license today for queuing. That said, if you guys notice any issues, like inability to hear me or excessive background noise like my cat jumping around or air conditioning running, please let me know. I tried to do some testing over the weekend, and I think I worked out most of the bugs. Yeah, I think that the big issue with this game is that it's harder to find your way around if you don't already know where you're intended to go. Right, where are other portals? There's got to be more keys here. We could go through the temple transport to get there. That might be the fastest way. Let's do that. Hit this thing, no reason to dork it again. There is a morph ball thing you can take there, but it's not necessary to progress. Alright, we don't want to go this way. We've already been to Tortoise Bog. We can take this morph ball thing, see where it goes. Okay, did I make that up? No, I did not. Alright, where are we at now? Hey people, thanks for the hosts. Appreciate that. What's the deal with Federation Force? All I remember was that I was streaming when it was announced at E3 and everybody groaned when they talked about it. Like, what kind of a game is it? It's clearly not an actual Metroid game, right? Cool, Spikey. I was suspicious of that. Oh, right, rock and roll. That's cool. So if I see a dead Luminoth, scan it and then double check the hint and I can see exactly which one it's referring to. Sure. Chibi? Is Samus even in the game? Sounds weird. Is Retro involved in any way? Oh, really? Yeah, so we're thinking the groans were just a result of this isn't, like, Metroid Prime 4 or the next Metroid game. I'd love to see Retro try to make a 2D Metroid game. As much as I like the Prime titles, like the 2D games are my preferred domain. I've been trying to save the best for last by starting with the Prime series on stream. Well, I guess they've got this big IP that they're not really taking advantage of. And the Metroid game universe is pretty cool. Do a Metroid Pikmin crossover. No reason why they can't exist in the same world. Right, take the portal that's in here. First of all, are there any dead Luminoth around here? You can just run around the dark world with the dark visor on all the time. The analog nub is actually quite good. I have a new 3DS for streaming. It certainly gets the job done. I don't have any major complaints about it. Here's a door that I could potentially open. Previously I wouldn't have been able to open. Sonic security response. Alright, well. Can we do that? We have to confirm the tone. Top left, alright, it goes clockwise. Sure. It's incorrect. Yeah, chill out, buddy. Nope, that's wrong. Looks like I have to be facing it. Okay, that's correct. That's also correct. Also correct. Is there a fourth one? It might just be that I have to like shoot through these four here. Yeah, looks like I have to be facing it to see what happens, which is smart. They make you do that. Hey, is this an ammo upgrade? Because that'd be swell. Sure is. Look at that. I'll be playing the deluxe version of Link's Awakening. Unless if there's like some pretty ridiculously huge differences between versions of games, I'll probably play the most recent version of the title when playing on stream. So, like, a game I can describe as being pretty ridiculously different would be Final Fantasy IV. 3D remake is pretty different from the 2D version. Let me go with the bullet bomber trick. There we go. That's much faster. Crazy music to chill out. Alright, we haven't actually been down here. I bet that leads to something. Let's go in that direction and see what we find. And then games where, you know, the two versions are wildly different, but one is just strictly better in every way. Like Final Fantasy III, I'll probably only be playing Final Fantasy III for the DS. I will not be playing the NES version. Similarly, I will probably only be playing Dawn of Souls. I will not also play the... Holy crap! And some Metroid. I will not also be playing the NES Final Fantasy I. Hold on. There we go. Jeez, Metroid. Why you gotta be so rude? Eponymous. Hey, Skylock. Thanks for the host, man. I appreciate it. Totally. Dead Luminoth. There's still a access in here, right? Hold up. Wait a minute. Let me add some pimpin' to it. There's nothing else to do in this room, but we can't get in here. Final Fantasy VI. It's tough to say. The Super Nintendo version has the best sound, just because the GBA sound isn't quite as good. Yeah, okay. Scan one and not the other. Found a few of the keys, that's what I'm working on right now. I believe I never explored this room before. It maybe is in here somewhere. The PS1 version is clearly worse because of the loading times, which are not a problem in the other releases. The GBA version is slightly worse because it includes a worse sound chip and worse, slightly worse graphics. Although the GBA version does benefit from a new translation. Translation of FF6 isn't particularly bad, but the new translation is quite a bit more accurate. So I'd say some combination of the translation from the GBA version and the original graphics and music from the Super Nintendo version for Final Fantasy VI. Which is what I ended up playing on stream. I did the GBA version with some ROM hacks that restored some of the original Super Nintendo stuff, like the original color palette. They had to change the color pretty wildly in the GBA version, because if you guys will remember, the GBA screen was super dark, and Final Fantasy VI is already a pretty dark game, so they turned the color saturation all the way up. Which is fine if you're playing it on a non-backlit GBA screen, but if you're playing it on an emulator or on the GBA, the original GBA, not the SP, you're going to have a bad time. This is the Wii version of Prime 2, that's correct. Yeah, the HD version for mobile is fine. I've played through it. I don't like that graphical style as much, but that's completely my personal preference. I prefer like the old school Super Nintendo sprite style. Normally we wouldn't be able to come here safely. Okay, cool. We needed to have the light suit to be able to survive all these particles everywhere. Yeah, I agree, Chaos. Just... no? I thought it was like something I could blow up. Turns out, it is not. Doesn't show up on the scanner either. Okie dokie. Works for me. Alright, so I'm not following a guide, but I do have a list of the number of keys in each area so that I know when I'm done with an area I can move on to another one. There are 3 keys total in the Sky Temple grounds, and I found 2 of them, so I have to go find the last one, and then we can move on to the Aegon Waste perhaps. I think this is a good component in a game that has you searching for things, letting you know how many are in an area and how many are still remaining that you haven't found yet, so you're reducing the amount of backtracking and recovering areas you've already been to. A really good implementation of this is the secret little like squiddy things you have to find in Link Between Worlds. There's a clear indicator on the map of how many are in each area and how many you found and how many are still remaining, without telling you exactly where they are, just letting you know, hey, you can, you know, rule this area out, you found everything here. You don't have to keep returning here and searching. To an Aegon Torvus and Sanctuary. I don't really care too much for ROM hacks. I mean, outside of translation hacks, which are necessary to play certain games like Mother 3, and outside of the palette and sound correction hack that I used to play the GBA version of Final Fantasy VI. I had played Final Fantasy VI a bajillion times. It's my favorite Final Fantasy. So when I played it on stream, I figured, let me do a version that I've never done before. I know the Super Nintendo translation well enough that I can point out differences when playing the GBA version. But in general, I won't install hacks just for the fun of it, unless it offers some real service or correction over the original. Alright, so I've got one from this area. Select the reliquary. There are other portals. We got this one. This is by where our ship is. Right. I don't think we've done that. That means we can get to it from where we are now. Bit of a walk. Go left. Down. Yeah, the music in Final Fantasy X Remaster is leaves something to be desired. If I had a PS4, / I knew that the PS4 was including an option to use the original soundtrack, I would have played it on there, but I've already started on the PS3 and I don't think the save will carry over, so I'll go ahead and finish it. That said, X is a game that it's possible I'll revisit. I've said that I want to complete one full playthrough of every awesome game ever made. It doesn't completely mean that we won't come back. Good thing. Like another way through here that I don't know about? No? This counts as a high yield explosive. Yeah. control panel is now useless. Okay. anyway, you know, I said we'll complete one full playthrough of awesome games, but there are some games that are so awesome they merit a second visit, like Chrono Trigger, for example. There are some games that are short enough that it is worth a second visit. There are some games that have multiple versions that are significantly different, like Final Fantasy IV. And there are some games that have multiple branching paths, like Mass Effect. I'll probably do a Renegade playthrough of Mass Effect someday. We're doing a non-Renegade playthrough at the moment. Still be driven by viewer decisions, but whenever the viewers aren't making the decisions, we'll kind of tend toward the Renegade options. Thanks, D-Rock. I guess I could have scanned something if I hit that before they bumped out of their eggs. Alright, so we haven't been in this portal yet, so I theorize that there's going to be something here when I go through the portal. Let's try to test that. Here, a high yield explosive. No. Skipping the portal if I go this way. There it is. Nice, PK Starship. I'm going to do a full playthrough of all the Pokemon games at some point on stream. I think that would be a lot of fun. I'm going to have to find a solution for my save games, though. I can probably overwrite all my saves except for my Pokemon X save, because I've gone to all the trouble of transferring my Pokemon from the older generations on X. I don't really care about losing the old save files since I've already moved Pokemon off of them. I guess when I get to Pokemon X, I would just play Y instead of X. Mutant strain of Venom Weed. Poisonous plant attracts into the ground if threatened. Adapted to life in Dark Aether. Although I'll have to play the really early, like, GBA titles on an emulator. I probably won't have any way to get those Pokemon off there and onto an actual game. That's okay. I never came in this room before. I'm entirely sure where this is going, but hey, let's check everything out, see what we can find. Aha! Well, that's our last one. Good to know. Nice. Yeah, D-Rock. You get motion sickness from this game, Broken One? Do you get that when you're playing it yourself or just watching it on stream? I could see watching it on stream being an issue with the way that I'm moving the Wiimote around all the time. I'd be curious to see whether that's a problem for all first-person shooter games or if it's specific to games where you're controlling it with a Wiimote, moving the camera around. Alright, let's go to Aegon Wastes next. I usually like water type starters. I'm a Squirtle man. Team Squirtle. Did you hear the whole thing about how Tycho from Penny Arcade had never watched the anime, so he assumed that Blastoise was pronounced Blastois. Seems totally reasonable. Worse when you're watching. Yeah, it's my wife Andrea gets really bad motion sickness. She gets it from driving. She has to be in the driver's seat and she's fine, but if someone else is driving, particularly if it's a bumpy road and she's not in the front seat, you can get really sick. Sucky. Ouch. Tycho's my hero, man. Yep, I've got the light suit now. Excitement of excitements. Cool, will do, D-Rock. Thank you. It seems like they're here at the end game when you're going back and getting the keys. It's like, go to the maps and then go to each area that has a portal, and there's probably a key somewhere within the restricted area of the portal. Right. Did we establish that there are two? Let me double check my thing here. I think there are two in Aegon Wastes, right? Yeah. Oh, geez, broken one. Well, it won't be much longer. We got about 30 minutes, and then we're switching to Xenoblade Chronicles from 2 o'clock to 4 o'clock Pacific, and then from 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock, it's Final Fantasy X. I'll be taking a brief break. Got a little bit of a sore throat, so after Metroid Prime, I'm going to go grab something to drink, maybe take care of feeding the cat so that they chill out. Wanted to send a thank you again to two new patrons on Patreon. Deidreark, this real-life friend of mine, subscribed today, as did Little D-Piece. Thank you both. I'll be getting your rewards out. Some Sphere Point discounts, monthly Sphere Point allowances, access to the, Mumble server, access to the forums, and so on. If you are unable to subscribe but still would like to get some bonus Sphere Points to spend on voting for games, you can do some bounties. You go to bounty.marsted.com. You can check out my YouTube channel. I've got tons and tons of videos on there that I would love to add timestamps to, of like, you know, this is the time in Metroid Prime 2 where I got to the boss that's named Quadraxis or whatever. What timestamp does that appear at? It's convenient for people to go back through and watch them. It also makes the videos show up in search results when people are searching for a specific game and a specific boss. So if you're unable to support on Patreon, but you'd still like to help out and get some bonus Sphere Points, check out that bounty page. If you don't know what the hell I'm talking about when I say Sphere Points, on this channel I have a special currency that you earn just by hanging out in chat. And this is the one I can't get through, I gotta go all the way around. We're gonna go left up here and go there. You can check your Sphere Point total by typing !SP. The main use of Sphere Points at the moment is to vote on the next game that we're gonna play. You go to vote.marsted.com and check it out. Sup, Hype? You got it, Chaos. Vote.marsted.com, there's a list of the games that are in queue. If you followed already, you have enough Sphere Points right now to vote for the next game. You get a 100 Sphere Point bonus for following, and it costs 60 to vote. Those games have all been pre-vetted by me. They're games that I would be happy to play on stream anyway, so voting just kind of pushes a game to be the next one we play. Your vote will count whether it wins immediately or not. Like, once a game wins, the other games stay on the list and they keep their vote total, so it'll eventually get played if you start investing in it now. Later, PK Starship, thanks for hanging out. Thank you for following. It's good to have you. What can you do on Mumble? Well, to be honest right now, let's see, is this... Okay, so there's probably a thing here if I can find the portal. I stay in Mumble, but on mute and deafened most of the time that I'm at my computer but not streaming. So if you wanted to have like a one-on-one talk with me that's not during stream, like to talk about stuff that's stream growth or donations or things you're not comfortable talking about live, you can reach me there. If you pop into Mumble, you can send me a private message and it'll give me a little pop-up. So if I'm around, I can hop on my headset and talk to you. Also, theoretically during Subblock, I'm in the subscribers channel of Mumble if you wanted to pop in the channel and talk to me live about whatever game you picked. That's up to you. So far, no one's taken me up on that. I don't want subscribers in live chat all the time because it doesn't scale. Eventually, there'll be too many people in there and we'll all be talking on top of each other. It's bad enough with me and like three other people during Final Fantasy XIV. All right, let's look around and see if we can find secrets. Going the right way. Thank you. Thanks, guys, for Katie's gonna take it, especially with Spikey's new horde of Sphere Points from doing that bounty. I believe that my domain link should work now every time without you getting a weird error message. If you go to marsed.com, it should redirect here. You go to vote.marsed.com, bounty.marsed.com, or schedule.marsed.com. They should all redirect immediately to the related Google Docs. For a while, there was an error message that was popping up that you had to F5 to get rid of, but GoDaddy told me they fixed it. But if anyone is still having issues using any of those three links I mentioned, let me know. Let's keep the visor on, just in case. That's an ing. Different than the thing that I'm looking for. Never open this green door. What the hell is green again? Is that like a super missile? It's got a super missile, right? Let's see. Another green door. Oh, this is an area that we've been to before. It's from a different direction. Alright, well, I don't know if I want to go this way. I don't know if there's a secret this way. Yeah, mumbles a voice chat program like TeamSpeak. Not just yet, dear. I'll let you know. It looks like the games that are vying for the top position right now are Skies of Arcadia, keep wanting to call Legend of Gaia League of Legends. Force of Habit from the LOL. Legend of Legaia and Phoenix Wright. Although there's a good chance that, whatchamacallit, could play the Dark Horse. Secret of Evermore could come from behind and take it. You just need someone to drop one of their nukes. Nice, Buckin. You're watching on YouTube? I was looking around. I mean, maybe that way. I feel like I'm straying a little too far from the portal room. Also, that's like the first portal room you ever find, so I'd be shocked if it actually has something to do with that. Let's back up. We did see a Luminoff corpse in one of these rooms behind us. I don't think this is the right way. Yeah, Skies has a decent chance though, especially because Spikey just got a boatload of sphere points for running those bounties I was talking about. Yeah, let's go towards this portal. We haven't been there yet. This was the shortcut we just opened and bailed out on. It's closer to one of those separate portals we're used to seeing. Yeah, warning my Patreon video, I made it in February of this year before I'd actually started streaming, or like in my first week of streaming, so I needed to completely record that from scratch. Apparently I was like super nervous or something when I was recording it. Just want to see. Deep purple juice. I think there might be a secret. Where are we at now? Isn't this where we saw Luminoff? Yeah, there's totally Luminoff ports here, so there's got to be one in here, right? Aha! No, it's not it. There is a Luminoff corpse in here, so I think that this is where we want to be. Those things are floating around everywhere. Is there like a way up somewhere in here? Look, I think. Totes a dead Luminoth in here, so there's got to be a main cache somewhere, right? I would think. Not in here, apparently. Good books. Articles or advice on building a really good RPG. You make them a side product. How to make an RPG? Geez, I don't know. Most of my favorite RPGs are Japanese, and the information is not particularly forthcoming on how to make those. Where could it be in this room? Let me not use this for a second. Unless if it's something I have to see from up high. I try to kill the little Englings on the ground so I'm not seeing them in my vision anymore. You got a ways to go. It'll probably be the game that replaces Xenoblade Chronicles. We're gonna beat that. I think we're gonna beat that before any other games that aren't called Metroid or Zelda. Alright, those are all dead now. Let's keep looking. Kinda hard to like make out the differences between different areas. Yeah, loot effects, I think I agree. If I were to make an RPG out of nowhere, that's the best thing I could think to do is play a lot of RPGs, think about what you like and dislike about the different ones. Gotta be one in this room, right? This whole area is suspicious. I will take a hint. Is there in fact a key in this room, doomed entry? I'm just not seeing it. Maybe I feel like if there's one in here, it's not on the bottom part of the room. It's got to be higher up, right? Oh, the key ones have their own name and logbook entry. I would have to see them in the light version of the world. Let me look at the logbook here. Marsh before a fortress in front. There's not one in this room, but I'm close. Okay, thank you guys. I'm trying to think, which way did I just come from? Two exits. I tend to want to leave from the higher ground. It's usually easier to get down than it is to get up, you know? Which she said. This way. Ooh, that sounds really cool. Broken One. I'd play the hell out of that. Hey, welcome back, Skyhawk. I was saying, Skyhawk, that, warning on that Patreon video, I made it in, like, February of this year within, like, a week of me starting streaming, so I really need to redo it. Kind of refined what I want my channel goal to be since then. Oh, secret platform. Oh, there it is. Probably need to use the platforms to get to it. Go. Jump, jump, jump. Like, once you shoot it, it's kind of hard to see at that point. Right. Over on this guy. Probably jump over on this thing. Can't get up on that once it comes down. Yeah, balance is going to require some pretty extensive testing by folks. Oh, you're kind to say so, Skyhawk. Thank you. I might, like, save the text and just re-record it. What kind of games have you been playing, Skyhawk? I guess that is... I've heard that is actually quite important when pursuing a Twitch partnership to have something unique that you're trying to do. Like, there was a guy on the Twitch subreddit today who was like, what the heck, I've got 100 concurrent viewers every day and I keep getting denied for partnership, what's wrong with my channel? And they're like, well, dude, all you do is play Counter-Strike. And that's cool, you can have a cool channel where you play Counter-Strike, but they're completely saturated with people who just do that. So you have to find something that you want to do that makes you different. I saw a guy who's trying to make his stream about, like, doing live playtesting for indie games that just went into alpha. It sounds pretty awesome. He's having some trouble getting started, but... Well, this is where I was going in the first place. Let me turn back around here. I got one of the keys, but I think there might still be something in the Dark Oasis room. It'll just be that they're super close to each other. Have, like, some kind of MMR system, so it would be less of an RPG... Broken One is in, like, you're moving through the game and experiencing the story. It's like RPG mechanics, RPG stats, right? Blind playthrough, nice. Nihilator Beam is pretty hot, D-Rock. Yes, I'll be playing on Saturday. I'm trying to wrap up before I switch to the voting system I talked about at vote.marstead.com, where you can vote on the next game we're going to play. I had a system whereby people could donate a one-time amount to add a game to the list. And it didn't scale at all. Like, it was kind of sucky for people because they donate and then they're still seeing their games being played months later. We still haven't finished them. So I'm going to use the next few Saturdays to just put time in to try to finish those games up. It's going to be Ogre Battle, Secret of Monkey Island, Silent Hill 2, and Albert Odyssey. All games that I'm enjoying, but I feel like getting to see them once every 3 weeks for 90 minutes isn't really doing them justice. Also, then eventually you'll get to have a Saturday where Marstead's just losing his shit over Silent Hill 2 at length. Let me hit that ammo room since it's right there. He's on energy. Ammo room's like back up here, right? Yes, sir. Yeah, that's part of the intent of beating these games on Saturdays, Spikey. Keep them off the regular schedule. I've got a backlog that I'm trying to clear out now that I've got a new system in place. Oh, you know, it might be through this Phazon site room now that I've got the Annihilator Beam. Let's go back over there. What's up, D-Rock? Did I do something absurd? Not particularly smart. I think it's in that phase on site room, right? There's a lot of dead Luminoff out here. Alright, Chaos, enjoy your nap. Catch you later. That's the way it just came. Turn in around, girl. There we go. Ah, okay, very good. Oh, there's a secret in there, isn't there? Huh. Well, it's supposed to be that I can just avoid that damage. I don't think there's anything else to be found in there. Yeah, right. Do you have any interest in speedrunning, Skyhawk? I do not. I love watching speedruns, but I am not interested in playing them, and that's hurting me in the sense that there's a really huge community of speedrunning fans that I'm not really tapping into by not speedrunning any games. Occasionally they'll pop in to a casual playthrough and say, hey, I usually speedrun this. I can find out about them that way. So that could be a niche that you try to develop. Oh, right, these are Metroids, aren't they? Totes Metroids. Nice. That's exactly what we wanted to happen. Oh, I screwed up my jump there. Let's try it again. Banjo-Kazooie speedruns. Nice. What's the, what's, like, the average play duration of a, like, Banjo-Kazooie speedrun? Are you going to do it like any percent or 100%? Cool. Yeah, absolutely, Ludifex. I didn't see that panel. I haven't watched the VOD for it yet, but I get that sense too, that the speedrunning community is super cool. Everybody's friendly with each other. Sonic Boom. Yeah. That's the Banjo-Kazooie is part of like the whole tradition of like collect all the Gazorpazorps. You got to get all the Moodly Boots. Like that's fun. So you should do it. The core game itself isn't particularly difficult, but getting everything can be. Hear that lovely sound. Save up real quick. Broken one, I'll let me keep my ear to the ground. One of the cool things with developing a Twitch stream is you kind of get As you get bigger, you get gaming industry credentials that normally you'd have to like know somebody directly. So if I hear anyone's involved in the creation of any kind of RPGs, like bumping to anybody from BioWare or even some of the indie companies, I'll try to put you in touch. Maybe you can get some lessons learned. Oh, really? I didn't know that you needed close to 100% for that. Let me take this portal back just to see if there's if I can find some Ing in the light world. We got about 9 minutes here before we switch to Xenoblade Chronicles. I'm gonna take a short break in here. I got a bit of a sore throat and grab something to drink, run to the restroom, the cat feeding out of the way. Yeah, sure, man. I'm sorry I don't have any good resources to give to you immediately. I just haven't bumped into anybody yet, but I would be happy to help if I can find somebody. I'm excited. Your concept for your game sounds really cool. I want to play it. Probably doesn't have to do with being in there. Wherever it is, it's not going to show in this room, right? I think we had a boss fight in here some time ago. Seems familiar. Huh. Oh. It's What's up, buddy? Hey, I've never scanned you before, and he's red. Ooh. Okay, so this one's totally a room where there should be one. Yeah, there's totally a key in here. Okay. I'm gonna check out what this yellow room is and we'll come back because I know there's a key in there. Probably just like a straight run too, right? Maybe there's like a power bomb upgrade in here. Yeah, it, Broken One, if you get a prototype too, I would be happy to stream it. Like, I've got another indie developer who I met at TwitchCon that I'm going to try to play their game on stream. Sanctuary Fortress. Let me go get that. I'll come back here because I need to go to Sanctuary Fortress to get the remaining things anyway. Let me go back first because I know that there's a dark key. I don't get too turned around. Should be another way to get back up from this room, right? This thing maybe, right? Yeah. Yep, we'll do Banjo-Kazooie and Tui on stream. We'll do all of the awesome, rare, get the Gazorpazorp thingies. Because they're all very good. Get all 300 Hoodle Dorks. I think I'm good, D-Rack. I know there's one in that room now. I just gotta go hit a portal. Thank you, though. I don't want to be in here for this room. Portal in here, right? Should be. Yeah. Oh, no, 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 I know. It's in the Dark Oasis room. I found a name with a knot in there. I'm gonna get that key, and then I'll go save the game. I might run a few minutes over while I catch up here. Dark Oasis, right? In here. There it is. We go right. Double check to make sure I'm going in the right room once I get up there. I do like the idea of user-generated stories. That takes a lot of the burden off your shoulders, so to speak. Was the room I was just in, right? Yes. All right, so it's totally in here somewhere. Though that said, let's see if we can find it. Don't want to exit the room. Powerbomb. Now, hold up. This room... Aha. Yeah, there is way more of this room in the light world. There's power pump. Nice. Is there a floaty guy in here? Could be. Although maybe it's in the poison water. Taking a dip, taking a dip. There it is. Cool. Rock and roll. Yeah, it makes sense, Broken One. It seems like getting the mechanics together is going to be more challenging than, the story part, since you can offload some of that to your viewers. So I would say get some kind of prototype out there so you can start getting feedback on the battle mechanics and the design mechanics. Maybe even let the viewers... It's there's unfortunately, there's this really nasty, like... what's the word? Not taboo. Stigma, there we go. Against early access for indie games, but it's the correct way to get funding for your title. You don't, you're not a huge company, you can't afford to have a bunch of people help test your game. So as long as people know that what you're doing is testing and that's what they're helping to do, you know, for some low cost, I think that if you at least get a product out there for people to start commenting on, you can start making progress on it. Nice, D-Rock. Thank you for biting your tongue. I appreciate it. I know it can be hard. It's technically a half pipe room. You're technically a half pipe room. Jump. Go. And look at that. Right on time. Actually gonna save a little early. Alright guys, we're going to be back in 4 or 5 minutes. I'm going to switch over to Xenoblade Chronicles 3D, run to the restroom, feed the cats, and grab something to drink to help with my sore throat a little bit. We'll see you soon. Throw up the BRB.